हेलो, आई एम गणेश प्याकलावे, वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर। इन दिस सेशन वी विल सी वेपर कॉम्प्रेशन साइकिल एक्चुअल लर्निंग आउटकम। एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू डिस्क्राइब एक्चुअल वेपर कॉम्प्रेशन साइकिल एंड डिराइव एक्चुअल COP। इन द प्रीवियस सेशंस वी हैव स्टडीड द स्कीमेटिक डायग्राम ऑफ वेपर कॉम्प्रेशन साइकिल। वी हैव शोन VCC ऑन pH डायग्राम। नाउ इफ वील कंसिडर द प्रैक्टिकल कंसिडरेशंस इन टू अकाउंट, देन दिस डॉटेड लाइन रिप्रेजेंटिंग थेरोटिकल साइकिल विल गेट मॉडिफाइड इन टू एक्चुअल वन। इन एक्चुअल VCC द प्रेशर ड्रॉप कॉज ड्यू टू द फ्रिक्शन बिटवीन द रेफ्रिजरेंट एंड द ट्यूब वॉल इज कंसिडर्ड। देन देयर विल बी वायर ड्रॉइंग प्रोसेस, द प्रैक्टिकल कॉम्प्रेशन प्रोसेस, प्रैक्टिकल कंडेंसेशन प्रोसेस, ऑल दीज पैरामीटर्स आर कंसिडर्ड। सो वील स्टार्ट विद द इनलेट टू द कॉम्प्रेसर। फॉर थेरोटिकल VCC द अजम्पशन वॉज द रेफ्रिजरेंट लिविंग टू इवैपोरेटर वॉज एट सैचुरेटेड स्टेट, दैट इज पॉइंट दिस पॉइंट। Now, practically, there will be heat gain by this saturated refrigerant or vapor refrigerant present inside the evaporator. It will take the heat from the surrounding because the evaporator will be connected to the compressor by means of tube. That heat gain will increase the enthalpy of the vapor refrigerant. Thereby, there is also decrease in the pressure. We will see this at the time of the evaporation. But the first point is the gain in the heat. That's why there is a superheating of the vapor refrigerant from this point, that is suppose 0.1 dash to 0.1. So superheated vapor will enter into the compressor, which will get compressed actually. So here 1 to 2 is the actual compression process, while for theoretical VCC the compression was, yes, it is isentropic compression process, but for actual VCC it is actual compression process. So depending upon the specific heats, there will be the value of the compression index. Now this 0.2 is the actual compression process. So at 0.2, the more superheated vapor refrigerant is leaving the compressor. For theoretical, the exit refrigerant temperature was at this point, so there is more superheating caused due to practical considerations. Now the refrigerant leaving the compressor is to be condensed back to the liquid phase. For theoretical condensation process, this was isobaric condensation process from suppose this 2 dash point to this suppose 3 dash point. This was constant pressure, that is isobaric condensation process, in which the heat was rejected by the refrigerant to the surrounding. But practically, as there is a desuperheating from point number 2 to this saturated point, there will be some pressure drop. That will be inclination. It will be shown if I will enlarge much more this figure, then there will be inclined line from 2 to saturated curve. Further, the refrigerant will enter into the wet region and further pressure drop will occur because of the friction between this liquid or wet refrigerant and the tube. Then it will leave at saturated liquid condition for the theoretical VCC, but for the actual VCC, it will enter into the superheated region because of further continuation in the heat rejection by the refrigerant to the surrounding. So, point number 3 is representing actual exit condition of a subcooled liquid refrigerant from the condenser. Now, we can install P1 pressure gauge to the suction of compressor, P2 pressure gauge at outlet of the compressor, P3 pressure gauge at outlet of the condenser, and the decrease in the pressure can be calculated as P2 minus P3, which can be represented by del P, delta P condensation, which will be difference between P2 minus P3. Now, in the actual VCC also, here we are making the assumption of the expansion process as throttling process. In the throttling process, isenthalpic expansion is assumed. That's why we have drawn 3 to 4 line as parallel line to the pressure or constant isenthalpic line, that is H3 is equal to H4. Now, for saturated VCC, the refrigerant entering into the evaporator was supposed at this 4 dash, while for actual, as there is more subcooling, it will enter into the evaporator having lower dryness fraction than theoretical, which may be beneficial as there is increase in the refrigerating effect. Now, evaporator, constructionally, evaporator and condenser are of the same shape. The construction of the condenser evaporator will be same. That's why there are evaporator tubes as that of condenser tubes. So, when this wet refrigerant or neglecting this flashing of the liquid refrigerant, I can call this as a liquid refrigerant, which enters into the evaporator will gain the heat from the surrounding, which is to be cooled. Because of that, the flow of liquid refrigerant through the tube, the pressure will be decreasing. There will be decrease in the pressure of refrigerant when it flows through the evaporator. We can also measure the decrease in the pressure or pressure loss or pressure drop in the evaporator by taking the difference of P4 minus P1. Though theoretically the refrigerant is to be leaving the evaporator at saturated, but as evaporator is connected to the compressor, there is heat gain and that pipe leads to pressure loss of the vapor refrigerant. That's why point 1 is below the evaporator theoretical pressure. Now, this pressure drop is to be considered while designing the evaporator. For example, we require temperature in the evaporator minus 20 degree Celsius and it leaves at minus 22 degree Celsius. Then this pressure drop is to be considered for maintaining minus 20 degree Celsius. Accordingly, the pressure ratio is decided, and this minus 22 or minus 2 degree Celsius difference is considered while designing the evaporator. Now, the actual VCC, considering all the practical considerations, will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. This is the actual VCC. More accurate curve can be plotted on the pH chart of that particular refrigerant by installing n number of pressure gauges. For example, this is the schematic representation of actual condensation, for which there were only two pressure gauges. I can increase the number of pressure gauges. For example, this is suppose first, second, third, fourth, and up to n number. Then I can locate those points along with the corresponding temperature on the pH chart, and I can draw the smooth line from those points for getting the actual condensation. Same method is applicable to evaporation. So this is the actual VCC, and for comparison purpose you can consider the schematic diagram of a theoretical VCC. I can represent the VCC on pH chart. So suppose this is 1 to 2 is the isentropic compression, 2 to 3 is the isobaric condensation, 3 to 4 is the isenthalpic expansion, 4 to 1 is the refrigerating effect. Now measure the actual pressures and temperature, locate the point at inlet to compressor, outlet to compressor, outlet of condenser, inlet to the evaporator, and simply join those points, you will get the actual VCC. For further study, you can refer refrigeration and air conditioning by C.P. Arora and W.F. Stoker. Thank you.